Good morning students, I hope you all are well. So as we have done completed our chapter 1, that is from production and management. In this we have learned about different agricultural practices, different basic practices which are used for crop production and how we can manage all the process which are used, which are utilized in crop production. And we have also learned about the different agriculture equipments, like traditional equipments and about the modern equipments. Students, today we will do the extra question answers, the question answer which are framed from the between of the chapter, and these are very important for you. Okay, so let's see. The question one is, what is crop? So we have already discussed that crop means when same type of plant are grown on a large scale on the same patch of land, that is known as crop. If we grow wheat plant, that is cereal crop. If we grow and eat pulses plant, that is pulses crop. And if we grow any fruit plant on large scale, that is known as fruit crop. Okay. So let's see the answer. Same type of plants cultivated at one place on a large scale is called crop. The same type of plants cultivated at one place on large area is known as crop. Next is question 2 is, define agricultural field. Agriculture field is an area or the patch of land on which the crop or the plant is grown. So let's see the answer. It is the plot of land used for cultivation of crop plants is called agricultural field. It is a plot of land on which the crop plants are grown. Next is question 3 is, name the different cropping patterns in India. So students, we have already discussed that there are 3 different cropping patterns followed in India, which are kharif crop, rabi crop and the zayat crop. And we have already discussed that kharif crops are planted in the month of June, July and harvested in the month of September and October. Similarly, the rabi crops are planted in winter season and they are harvested in the April of the succeeding year. Next, zayat crops are which are planted in the rainy season and they are harvested in the that season only. Okay, and examples we talk about, so kharif crop examples are maize, millet. Examples of rabi crops are mustard, wheat, and of zayat crops are watermelon and muskmelon. So let's see the answer to question 3. 3 cropping patterns are there in India: kharif crop, rabi crop and zayat crop. Okay, so next is question 4. Who is the father of Green Revolution? Who is the father of Green Revolution? The student, first of all, you should know what is Green Revolution. Green Revolution means the drastic increase in the crop production by using HYB seeds. And 2 factors are also responsible for Green Revolution. First one is increase in farmland area, increase in agricultural field, and the second is using mixed cultivation. Okay, so the father of Green Revolution is Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, if we talk about the India. But if we talk about the at world level, then it is Dr. Norman Borlaug. Okay, next is question 5, expand HYB seeds. Expand HYB seeds. So here you have to write the full form of HYB seeds. So HYB seeds is for H for high, Y for yielding. Yielding means production varieties of seeds. So HYB seeds stand for the seeds which gives high yield of crop production. Next is question 6 is what is animal husbandry? So student, we have already discussed that in mixed cultivation the animals are also reared for getting animal products from them, for getting milk products, for getting meat, for getting egg. Okay, so the practice of breeding and raising livestock, livestock means cattle, is known as animal husbandry. So the rearing of animals to get animal products from them is known as animal husbandry. Next is question 7 is who is the father of white revolution? So there is an another term for white revolution is also there, that is known as Operation Flood. Okay, as the green revolution did to the crop production, similarly the white revolution did to the milk products and increase in the milk production. So it is developed by National Dairy Development Board, and due to which the production of milk increases. And the aim of this was to make the India a world leader in production of the milk. So let's see the answer. The father of white revolution is Dr. V. Kurien. Dr. V. Kurien is known as the father of white revolution, and he is also known as Amul Man. So student, these are the extra question answers of chapter 1. You have to do this question.